short review. If by some chance you haven't played Vice City yet, stop watching. Go out and get the PC version of the game. It's extremely good. It's better than the PS2 version. If you're still waiting for more information on Vice City, hi, I'm Greg Kasavin, and I'm going to tell you about the new PC version of the game. It's basically the same game as the PS2 release from late last year. The port of the game is quite similar in quality to the PC port of Grand Theft Auto 3 from last year. The game is available exactly 1 year after GTA 3 and marks the best sort of follow-up that you could possibly imagine to a game that was extremely good to begin with. No, this isn't a true sequel. It's not completely different. It's got similar gameplay. It's got a similar kind of open-ended sandbox kind of feel to it, where you're set loose in this kind of crime-infested city and are able to do pretty much whatever you damn well please. But Vice City adds a lot of cool new features, new types of vehicles like motorcycles and helicopters and seaplanes, new gameplay. There's some indoor scenarios. You could bail out of moving vehicles now, new weapons, new characters, and of course there's an entirely new setting. The game now takes place in sort of a very pleasant looking 1986 era city called Vice City. It's modeled after Miami, Florida. It's much more pleasant than the sort of oppressive Liberty City setting of GTA 3 and gives the game a very different sort of feel to it. There's also something like 8+ hours of licensed 80s music to provide the soundtrack for Vice City. If you're a fan of this type of music, you can pretty much go out and buy this game, if only for the soundtrack. It's worth it for that reason alone. And so again, you know, considering it's only been a year since the last GTA game, this is a really impressive achievement and a very successful follow-up to a truly outstanding game. Unlike in GTA 3 and Vice City, you play as a specific character. His name is Tommy Vercetti. He's fresh out of the slammer and already has gotten himself back into trouble. Basically, he's part of a drug deal that's gone bad, and the premise of the game is that you're trying to get back at the crooks who screwed you over and, get back the money that you owe to the mob. But, you know, within that context, even though you'll meet a lot of interesting characters and see some really well-done cinematic cutscenes, this isn't a linear game by any means. You could go through it at your own pace, just like GTA 3, and engage in plenty of different types of missions and various activities. This city of Vice City is just your playground. You could do whatever you want in it. You could, you know, go on a rampage and get the cops on your tail and try to outrun them, or deliver pizzas from a little moped, everything in between, cause however much mayhem you want, or try to abide by traffic laws if you want. You could play this game any way you please. That's what was so revolutionary and amazing about GTA 3, that it put you in this clockwork city, and Vice City retains all those great aspects, but gives them a fresh coat of paint and introduces a lot of new gameplay within that setting. The missions in Vice City are generally more involved than those of GTA 3. They're kind of multi-stage affairs. You don't just go from point A to point B, but you'll often have to, maybe take out various targets around the city, or go drop something off to pick something else up that you then have to deliver somewhere else. It's not just a straightforward type of thing, and since you can't save your progress during a mission, they end up being kind of one dramatic take. You with tons of enemies on your tail trying to elude them, or all kinds of things like that. Since there's so much activity in this game, since the physics are so realistic, you're never going to experience exactly the same outcome for a mission if you play it through multiple times. That's really at the core of the appeal of this game. It's just so dynamic, and it'll keep surprising you. Even if you've played GTA 3 to death, chances are you're just going to see a lot of new stuff in Vice City, especially with things like motorcycles on the road now, and new weapons to mess around with, things like that. Vice City, of course, came out on the PlayStation 2 originally, but this version looks a lot better. It supports high resolutions, the textures are sharper, you could set the draw distance a lot further, so if you have a machine that exceeds the minimum specs, you'll get a nice, smooth frame rate, practically non-existent loading times, and just a very, very smooth gameplay experience all around. With that said, from a technical standpoint, Vice City doesn't look amazing. It's more a great-looking game thanks to its style and just just the realistic physics in the environment, the way the cars collide with each other, things like that, all looks very convincing. But the audio actually does an even better job of establishing and maintaining the atmosphere of the game. As mentioned, this game has hours and hours of 80s music in it. Like all previous GTA games, the soundtrack is actually, the radio stations that you'll listen to when you jack various people for their vehicles. So there's like a rock station and a metal station, a new wave station, a rap station, all kinds of stuff. If you like any type of music from the 80s, chances are you're going to find a lot of recognizable hits on this soundtrack, and it's really just makes for some very fun experiences as you're kind of rampaging through the town and listening to kind of softcore 80s rock or something like that. It's very unique in that respect. Vice City also has some exceptionally good voiceover. It's got some top Hollywood talent in it. Ray Liotta provides the voice of Tommy Vercetti, and you've got other guys like Burt Reynolds, even Miss Cleo does a voice for the game, so there's top-notch voice talent. The characters are memorable and very well written, and altogether this game is just very sharp and clever. It's been reviled in the mass media as being this sort of killing simulator. It's just a game about murder, but of course that's not true at all. If you actually play this game, you'll see that it's got a lot of really smart and biting sarcasm in it, just some very clever, portrayals of 1980s excess, things like that. It's just a very well-done game all around. Vice City, of course, is a single-player only game. There's no multiplayer mode or anything, but for a single-player game, you'd be hard-pressed to find another game that offers more lasting value, more variety than this one. It's just the sort of game that, long after you're done with the story missions, which will take you a while to begin with, you can still be, goofing around in the city and experiencing new things and finding new kind of hidden features and little in-jokes, things like that. There's just a ton to offer here, so if you're a fan of GTA 3 or if by some unholy chance you've missed out on these games so far, definitely check out Vice City. It's a one-of-a-kind game, unless you count GTA 3 that inspired it. Both games are exceptional, and Vice City is just a great follow-up.
The home of rebellion.